Blackstone Publishing presents How Baseball Happened, Outrageous Lies Exposed, The True Story Revealed, by Thomas W. Gilbert, with an introduction by John Thorne. This book is read by George Newbern. Introduction. To those who care about the past, great institutions may be of most interest when they begin. Why? Because in their sparse fields and green shoots may be seen essential attributes less visible when the endeavor is in full flower. How did photographs come to be, or movies, or automobiles, or computers? All origins stories fascinate. In baseball, which is the matter at hand, why 9 innings, 9 men, and 90 feet? Why a bat and ball, and later a glove? Why are the bases set in a circle? Indeed, why baseball, as a game, then a sport, then an emblem for the nation in which it was formed, if not truly born? To the fan of today, the answer seems so obvious as to require no explanation. Yet to historians of the game, they have been, until quite recently, enduring mysteries. In the 1840s and 1850s, the reasons for the rise of baseball would have been, first, the novelty and excitement of play, an unseemly activity for grown men. Second, the opportunity for urbanites to exercise amid fresh air in a sylvan setting. And third, the assertion of a binding national identity, independent of John Bull and his national game of cricket. As America entered the 1860s and was nearly torn asunder, other reasons emerged as to how baseball happened and why. About 10 years ago, when I was completing my own book on the early game, I was asked at a cocktail party, "What, after all your years of research, remains the great unanswered question in baseball?" With no forethought, and yet not skipping a beat, I offered, "What is it that is so satisfying about a game of catch?" In my 8th decade, I am a bit closer to an answer, I suspect. The simple idea of to and fro suffices to explain all that was once complex. I still follow baseball every day, watching more than 100 games each season. Baseball may be the one thing that I have cared about unceasingly since I was 5. In my earlier work, I went forward, advancing analytic notions of how the game might be improved, or at least measured more realistically. I began to wonder about what might really be going on, hidden from sight, yet discernible from the game's statistical residue. More recently, I have looked back to a time a century and more before my birth to provide a firmer grasp of baseball's serpentine story and the lies and legends that have attached to it. The pleasure I take in baseball games today is enriched by a knowledge of distant games and long-dead players no less vivid for their seeming invisibility. I attended my first games at the Polo Grounds and Ebbets Field, and my worship of baseball heroes, first on cardboard, then on television, and at last at the ballpark, began with Duke Snider and Jackie Robinson. Today my favorites, a grown-up may not be permitted heroes, right, are the players and innovators whose stories are fascinating because what they did first. Doc Adams, George Wright, Al Reach, King Kelly. Oh, I could go on. Why baseball? One may approach the question philosophically, socially, culturally, and of course historically. Tom Gilbert looks not in box scores, in game accounts, or in baseball rules changes, and certainly not in baseball's own ridiculous creation tales, but instead in larger cultural, economic, and social trends, and in the whole lives and times of the men who played, promoted, and wrote about the game. In his splendidly created necropolis, he summons the ghosts of Jim Creighton and Joe Start and other ancient worthies to cavort once more. When journalists become historians, a path often taken, they retain the useful guidelines of their former craft: who, what, where, when, and how. In their invaluable works, Robert Henderson and David Block address the origins of bat and ball games, the where and when around the world. My own baseball in the Garden of Eden moved from Europe and Africa to America.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.